and welcome back to our catechism. We're on our fourth question already, and our question today is, why must the Redeemer be truly God? Well, it's all to do with why the Redeemer is the one rescuer we need. So can you guess what person is needed to rescue these people who are in need?
Oh no, I'm stuck up this tree. Which pup can come and rescue me?
Ha 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 ha. I'm going to destroy this building.
I need help!
I can't get him on my own. I need...
Captain America!
To find the answer to our question, we are going to go on a clue hunt. So hop in the car with me and let's go. Did you see what happened then? Michael came off and Alex went on for him. He was his substitute, and that is our first clue to why our Redeemer must be God, because we need a Redeemer who is a perfect substitute. Our Redeemer has to swap places with sinful people. He can't be messed up with sin like us. He's got to be a perfect Redeemer. He's got to be so precious and valuable that he can swap places with all the sinful people that come to him. And that is why our Redeemer must be God. Our second clue is we need someone to wash away our sins and give us forgiveness. That means our Redeemer must be God. We have hurt God, and that means he's the only one who can forgive us. So that is why our Redeemer must be God. Well, here we are at our third clue, because we need a Redeemer who can give life. Death is the saddest thing in our world, and it affects every single person. So we need a Redeemer who can beat death and give us life. God is the only one who can give life and beat death. So our Redeemer must be God. He must be a life giver. So what have we learned from our clue hunt? Well, our Redeemer must be our perfect substitute who can forgive us and give us life. So who is he? Acts chapter 2, verse 24 says, "But God raised him from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep its hold on him." Jesus is our perfect, forgiving, death-shattering Redeemer. Because he is God, his sacrifice on the cross is perfect and effective. It works. So, can we answer our question? Why must the Redeemer be truly God? Oh, we've got some blanks again. Can you fill them in? What did you get? Why must our Redeemer be truly God? That his suffering might be perfect and effective. Well done. That's our question for this week. Enjoy learning it, and we'll see you next time.